So guys, in the previous video, we saw the figure of third ventricle and other related structures that help us locate the structures like corpus callosum, septum, pellucidum, fornix, and those structures that help or that form the boundaries of the lateral ventricle. And we also discussed about some of the boundaries of the lateral ventricles. So now let's have a solid discussion, and so that we can make a note for revision during our exam time. Okay, so let's start with third ventricle. Okay, so if you have not watched the previous video, the video is in the I button. You can click and find the video and watch that before you watch this video, so that you can have a quick overview and you can also have a look at the picture of the, sorry, have a look at the photo figure that will help you understand this theory point. Okay, so, and in some places in the previous video, for the regular viewers who watched my previous video, some points in somewhere I have mentioned third ventricle as lateral ventricle due to in the flow while speaking. So please correct that. That's not lateral ventricle. If I have spoken somewhere lateral ventricle, it's third ventricle. Okay, so let's continue with the points of third ventricle. So first, what is third ventricle? So third ventricle, as discussed in the previous video, we told that third ventricle is an interthalamic space lined by ependyma. Yes or no? So let's write third ventricle is a interthalamic space lined by ependyma. Okay, and we discussed about the anterior wall, some of the boundaries, but we didn't mention earlier that how many boundaries does it presents. So let's discuss it now. So it presents anterior wall, posterior wall, roof, floor, and the lateral walls. Okay, so let's write over here. It presents ANT, okay, anterior by ANT, anterior wall, posterior is POST, okay, don't get confused, posterior wall, roof, floor, and lateral walls. Yes, so now first let's discuss about the anterior wall. Anterior wall. So anterior wall is formed by keep the figure aside, okay, in the previous video with the figure, we told that it is formed by, okay, let's start, I'll first write, formed by, just remember, two column of fornix, others were lamina terminalis, it is clear to you, lamina terminalis, okay, terminalis, एंड एंटीरियर कमिश्यर। एंटीरियर COMMISSURE, एंटीरियर कमिश्यर। ओके, द कमिश्यरल फाइबर्स आर दोज दैट जॉइन द टू हेमिस्फीयर्स। सो द एंटीरियर वॉल इज फॉर्म्ड बाय टू कॉलम्स ऑफ फॉर्निक्स लैमिना टर्मिनलिस, टू कॉलम्स ऑफ फॉर्निक्स लैमिना टर्मिनलिस एंड एंटीरियर कमिश्यर। ओके, नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द पोस्टीरियर वॉल। I hope you have kept the figure aside. If not, I'll again tell you, show you the figure, so that those who have not watched the previous video will help, will get a bit of idea. So posterior wall, again this is formed by supra pineal recess pineal body with recess and pineal recess other structures were posterior commissure and cerebral aqueduct. Yes or not? We mentioned in the previous video other structures were posterior PUST posterior commissure and cerebral, I hope it is clear to you, cerebral aqueduct. Okay, now let's discuss about the roof. Roof formed by ependymal lining, and while discussing about fornix, we mentioned that the fornix is separated from the ependymal lining through the telecoroidea. So the under surface of the telecoroidea will also form the as a contribution in forming the roof of the third ventricle. So we'll write under surface of the telecoroidea. Okay, under surface of telecoroidea and at the junction of the roof, at the junction of the roof with anterior and lateral walls. Okay, with the junction of the at the junction of the roof with anterior walls, there is the interventricular foramen. We discussed about it in the previous video while discussing about the fornix. We are also discussing over here at the junction of the anterior wall and the lateral walls. It is obvious that I cannot show the lateral wall from the in the figure. So at the junction of the anterior wall and the lateral wall, at the junction of the anterior wall and lateral wall is the interventricular foramen that helps in the communication of the third ventricle with the lateral ventricles. Okay, so let's write that at junction of roof with anterior wall and lateral wall is interventricular foramen. Okay, इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर फोरामिन, ओके, डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज और नॉट, आई बिकेम अ बिट कंसिस्टेंट. सो एट द जंक्शन ऑफ द रूफ विथ एंटेरियर वॉल एंड द लैटरल वॉल इज द इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर फोरामिन, एंड द फंक्शन ऑफ इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर फोरामिन इज, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड फोरामिन ऑफ मोनरो, एंड द फंक्शन ऑफ इट इज थ्रू दिस इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर फोरामिन द थर्ड वेंट्रिकल कम्युनिकेट्स विथ द लैटरल वेंट्रिकल. सो इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर फोरामिन और फोरामिन ऑफ मोनरो इज द एंटेरियो सुपेरियर कम्युनिकेशंस ऑफ द थर्ड वेंट्रिकल. ओके, वील अगेन डिस्कस अबाउट दिस वाइल डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एंटेरियो सुपेरियर कम्युनिकेशन एंड पोस्टेरियो इन्फेरियर कम्युनिकेशंस ऑफ द थर्ड वेंट्रिकल. सो पोस्टेरियो इन्फेरियर कम्युनिकेशंस ऑफ द थर्ड वेंट्रिकल आर द सेरिब्रल एक्विडक्ट थ्रू विच इट कम्युनिकेट्स विद द फोर्थ वेंट्रिकल. ओके, सो वील राइट अबाउट दोज थिंग्स. So we'll discuss about anterior wall, posterior wall, roof. Now we are left with the floor and lateral ventricles. Okay. So now let's discuss about the structures that form the floor. So floor is formed by optic chiasma. Floor is formed by optic chiasma, tuber cinereum. We'll locate again by showing you the figure. Tuber cinereum, infundibulum, which is the stalk of pituitary. Yeah, then mammillary bodies, we are discussing about the structures that form the floor. Okay, posterior perforated substances, these posterior perforated substances are, they lie below the optic chiasma. Okay, we can see it much better while seeing the inferior surface. While discussing about the inferior surface of the brain, we are discussing the medial surface. So posterior perforated substances, and final structure is the tegmentum of the midbrain. Okay, these structures form the floor of the floor of the third ventricle. Now we shall discuss about the structures forming the lateral wall. Okay, so lateral wall is formed by medial surface of the thalamus, hypothalamus, and hypothalamus sulcus, which separates this thalamus and hypothalamus. Okay, hypothalamus sulcus, and this hypothalamus sulcus is separates thalamus from hypothalamus. Okay, so separates this thing. Okay, separate hypothalamus sulcus separates thalamus from हाइपोथैलेमस। एंड दिस हाइपोथैलेमस सल्कस, दिस हाइपोथैलेमस सल्कस एक्सटेंड्स फ्रॉम इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर फोरामेन अप टू द सेरिब्रल एक्विडक्ट। ओके, सो वी टोल्ड अबाउट टू थिंग्स अबाउट द हाइपोथैलेमस सल्कस, सो डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज। आई थिंक आई गेस इट इज क्वाइट अ बिट रफ, नॉट दैट मच, अ बिट लिटल बिट ऑफ रफ वर्क सो दैट यू मे गेट कन्फ्यूज, सो आई एम रिपीटिंग इट वंस अगेन। Lateral wall is formed by the following structures, that is the medial surface of thalamus, hypothalamus and hypothalamus sulcus. Okay, and we have to discuss two points on hypothalamus sulcus, that is the first point is hypothalamus sulcus, about this hypothalamus sulcus. Okay, the hypothalamus sulcus is separating the thalamus from hypothalamus, and the second point is that it extends from the interventricular foramen. What? The hypothalamus sulcus extends from the interventricular foramen up to the cerebral aqueduct. Okay, so extends from interventricular foramen up to where? Up to the cerebral aqueduct. Okay, so up to cerebral aqueduct, extends from interventricular foramen up to the cerebral aqueduct. Now after this we shall discuss about the communications of the third ventricle and the clinicals of the third ventricle. Okay, so before discussing about those things we shall discuss about two points, that is one point about the columns of the fornix, two columns of the fornix, and one about the two thalami. So communications of third ventricle, communications. Okay, so as we have already discussed earlier, there are two structures helping in the communication of third ventricle with lateral ventricle and fourth ventricle. The one with that causes the communication with the lateral ventricle is the interventricular foramen, and the other one is cerebral aqueduct that helps to communicate with the fourth ventricle. Okay, so antero superior and the other is anterior superiorly third ventricle. Okay, anterior superiorly it communicates, it means third ventricle communicates with lateral ventricles by interventricular foramen. Nothing much to discuss or more, because we have already discussed so many times while discussing in the previous videos or before this interventricular foramen. Okay, and posteriorly with fourth ventricle by cerebral aqueduct. Okay, so the two communications, anterior superiorly communicates with the lateral ventricle by the help of interventricular foramen, and posterior inferiorly it communicates with the fourth ventricle by the help of cerebral aqueduct. Now we shall come to the communications, sorry, clinicals. So clinicals. Clinicals of third ventricle include some points that it is a narrow ventricle. Being narrow, it is often blocked by developmental deformities, often blocked by developmental deformities and tumors or developmental defects. Okay, it is narrow, so obstructed by developmental defect and also tumors. Easily it is blocked or obstructed. Okay, and this obstruction leads to raised intracranial inside the cranium, intracranial pressure in adults and hydrocephalus in infants. Okay, so this obstruction is causing increased intracranial pressure. Okay, increased intracranial pressure in adults and hydrocephalus. Hydrocephalus in infants. Okay, these are the two clinicals of third ventricle, and the final and third clinical is that the tumors in the third ventricle give rise to hypothalamic symptoms like diabetes insipidus, obesity, sexual disturbance, sleep disturbance, hyperglycemia and all these. Okay, so let's write those also. Tumors give rise to hypothalamic symptoms and those symptoms are diabetes insipidus, hyperglycemia glycosuria etc. and there is the other symptoms like sleep disturbance, sexual disturbance. These are the they can also be included. They are the like sexual disturbance and the obesity, sleep disturbance. These are also other hypothalamic symptoms. Okay, the major one are the diabetes insipidus, hyperglycemia, glycosuria etc. glycosuria. Okay, glycosuria. This is I was not able to write it over there, so I gave a dash and I wrote over there. Okay, hyperglycemia, glycosuria and diabetes insipidus. So this completes our discussion on third ventricle. Now we shall show a figure of it again, locating some of the structures that we didn't do while discussing about the in the previous video. So you can find the notes of these discussions in our Facebook page. The link will be provided in the description below. So this is the figure which those who have seen the previous video are familiar with it, but for the new one, You can have a look. So this is the tuber cinereum. Okay, this elevation, not elevations of it, little bit of elevation, this one. This one is the before mammillary body. This little bit of elevation is the tuber cinereum as labeled over here. This is the mammillary body. This is the aqueduct of midbrain or cerebral aqueduct. Okay. And these are the abenular commissure, posterior commissure we discussed earlier. And this is the optic chiasma. This is the optic chiasma. This one is the supraoptic chiasma. Above the optic chiasma, that is supraoptic chiasma. Same thing over here. Pineal recess, and above the pineal recess is the suprapineal recess. So you can have a close look. Those who have not drawn, you can draw it if you like, or if you want to have a photo, then you can get it into our Facebook page. The link is in the description below. So in this way we complete the discussions on the third ventricles with all the boundaries, all the structures that forms its boundaries, and some major clinicals. Okay, so let's come to the clinicals rapidly. It is narrow, so it is easily obstructed by developmental defects and tumors, and the obstruction in this ventricle is increasing the intracranial pressure. Intracranial means inside the cranium. Intracranial pressure in adults, and causing hydrocephalus in infants. Okay, the other symptoms are the tumors in the lower region. Okay, I forgot to mention tumors in the lower region give rise to hypothalamic symptoms. Like the hypothalamic symptoms are diabetes insipidus, hyperglycemia, glycosuria, sexual disturbances, obesity, sleep disturbances. Okay, so tumors in the lower part. So please guys, don't mind. So sometimes we get a bit confused, a bit congested over here. So if you have any queries, you can list it in the comment section below, or in the my email ID, it will be provided in the description box. So thank you guys.